second criteria is SSS similarity criteria. So if the corresponding sides of two triangles are proportional, then they are similar. So here, if we take these two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle DEF, these two triangles are there. Here sides are proportional given, means AB by DE is equal to BC by AF is equal to AC by DF. We have to show that these two triangles are similar. So first we have to write given quantities. So given triangle ABC and DEF, triangle DEA, such that AB by DE is equal to BC by EF is equal to AC by DF. We have to prove that triangle ABC similar to triangle DEF. Now here we have to construct that. We have to take point P and Q on DE and DF such that AB is equal to DP and AC is equal to DQ. Okay. So here we have to take point P and Q, and after that we have to join this PQ. Okay. So construction is here. Let point P and Q be on DE and DF such that this AB is equal to DP and AC is equal to DQ. Join PQ. Okay, so this is construction. Now we have to start proof. Okay, from this we have to start given. This is AB by DE is equal to, we have to take AC by DF. So AB by DE is equal to AC by DF. Now here AB is equal to DP and AC is equal to DQ. So this we have replaced by DP and DQ. So DP by DE is equal to DQ by DF. Okay. Now see here, DP by DE is equal to DQ by DF. So by converse of PPT, we can write PQ parallel to EF. Okay, so here we can write PQ parallel to EF by converse of PPT. Okay, now next. Now here PQ parallel to EF. So this corresponding angles are equal. So angle DPQ is equal to angle DEF. And angle DQP is equal to angle DFE. Okay, so first we have to write this. So angle DPQ is equal to angle DEF and angle DQP is equal to angle DFE. These two are corresponding angles. Okay. So if we write this DPQ is equal to DEF and DQP is equal to DFE, so these two triangles, triangle DPQ and triangle DEF, these two triangles are similar by AA criteria, because this angle DPQ is part of triangle DPQ and angle DQP is a part of triangle DQP is equal to the angles E and angle F respectively. So we can say that triangle DPQ similar to triangle DEF. Triangle DPQ similar to triangle DEF by A criteria. A similarity criteria. Okay. So these two triangles are similar. Now if triangles are similar, we definition of similarity. If triangles are similar, then sides are in proportion. So we can write DP bar DE is equal to PQ bar EF. Okay. Now here DP is equal to AB. That is by construction. So we can write AB bar DE is equal to PQ bar EF. Okay. Here since AB is equal to DP. Okay. Now, but here what we have? AB by DE is equal to BC by EF. So we can write here but AB by DE is equal to BC by EF. And here we have AB by DE is equal to PQ by EF. So we can write therefore PQ by EF is equal to BC by EF. So from this we can write PQ is equal to BC. Okay. Now we have PQ is equal to BC. Now I am writing this here. Now we have PQ is equal to BC. Okay. So if we are taking these two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle DPQ. So in triangle ABC and triangle DPQ, AB is equal to DP, AC is equal to DQ. This is by construction. And now we have PQ is equal to BC. So we have to write this first here. AB is equal to DP, AC is equal to DQ, and BC is equal to PQ. So we can write triangle ABC congruent to triangle DPQ by SSS criteria. Okay, this is congruence criteria. So triangle ABC congruent to triangle DPQ by SSS criteria. Now these two triangles are congruent. Okay, so triangle ABC congruent to triangle DPQ and triangle DPQ similar to triangle DEF. Okay, here we wrote here triangle DPQ similar to triangle DEF. So if two triangles are congruent, then these two triangles are similar also. So triangle ABC similar to triangle DPQ and triangle DPQ similar to triangle DEF. So we can write here, here ABC similar to DPQ and DPQ similar to DEF. So we can write therefore triangle ABC similar to triangle DEF. Okay, so if sides are in proportional, corresponding sides are in proportional, then we can say that these two triangles are similar. Triangle ABC similar to triangle DEF. Now we will see next theorem is a SAS similarity criteria. Okay, next theorem is SAS similarity criteria. That is third one, similarity criteria. So here, if in two triangles one pair of corresponding sides are proportional, so here AB by DE is equal to AC by DF, and included angle between them, that is angle A, it is in between AB and AC, and angle D, it is in between DE and DF. So angle A and angle D are equal, and we have to show that these two triangles are similar. So it is same like SSS similarity criteria. So first we have to write given, that is two triangles ABC and DF in which AB by DE is equal to AC by DF. So and angle A is equal to angle D, and we have to prove that these two triangles are similar. So construction is again same, point P and Q be on DE and DF such that AB is equal to DP and AC is equal to DQ. Join PQ, and again same we have to do here. So here what is given, AB by DE is equal to AC by DF. Instead of AB and AC, we have to put DP and DQ. It is by using construction. So DP by DE is equal to DQ by DF. So DP by DE is equal to DQ by DF. So by the converse of DPT, we can write PQ parallel to EF. And if PQ parallel to EF, corresponding angles are equal, angle DPQ is equal to angle DEF, and angle DQP we can write is equal to angle DFE. Okay, so these two triangles are similar by a criteria. So up to this, same proof is there. After that, here triangle ABC and in triangle DPQ, in triangle ABC and triangle DPQ, AB is equal to DP and AC is equal to DQ. By construction, AB is equal to DP, AC is equal to DQ, and angle A is equal to angle D, that is given. So we can write here triangle ABC congruent to triangle DPQ by SAS criteria. So these two triangles are congruent by SAS criteria, and this if we give here 2, so we can write again same. From 1 and 2, triangle ABC congruent to triangle DPQ and triangle DPQ similar to triangle DEF. Okay, so if these two triangles are congruent, they are similar also. So triangle ABC similar to triangle DPQ and triangle DPQ similar to triangle DEF. So from this we can write triangle ABC similar to triangle DEF. Okay, so if one pair of corresponding sides of two triangles are proportional, not equal, are proportional and included angle is equal, then we can say that these two triangles are similar by SAS similarity criteria. Okay, now we will take one remark and after that we will take example. Okay, we will take one remark. If two triangles ABC and DEF are similar, if triangle ABC similar to triangle DEF, then we can write sides are in proportion. If triangles are similar, then sides are in proportion, that is AB by DE is equal to BC by EF is equal to AC by DF, and that is equal to, if we add this all, that is AB plus BC plus AC upon DE plus EF plus DF. That is, we can write AB by DE is equal to BC by EF is equal to AC by DF is equal to, this means perimeter of triangle ABC upon, this means perimeter of triangle DF. So if two triangles are similar, then their corresponding sides are in proportional and their corresponding perimeters are also in proportion. Okay, that is a remark. So keep in mind this, if triangles are similar, then sides are proportional and their perimeters are also in proportion. Okay, they can ask example on this also, perimeter of triangles. Okay, so keep this remark in mind. Okay, now we will take examples. Okay, now we will solve example based on SSS and SAS similarity criteria. Okay, so first example is in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, CM and RN are medians. So two triangles are there, ABC and PQR. CM and RN are medians, and what is given? Triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR given. We have to show that CM upon RN is equal to AB upon PQ, and second one, triangle CMB similar to triangle RNQ. Okay, so first we will start, what are the given quantities? Okay, so here triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR given. Okay, so if triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR, if two triangles are similar, we can write corresponding angles are equal and corresponding sides are in proportion. Okay, so angle A is equal to angle P, angle B is equal to angle Q,
angle C is equal to angle R, and corresponding sides, that is AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR is equal to AC upon PR. Okay, now we have to show that this first and second. Okay, now first we will show that this triangle CMB similar to triangle RNQ, and if these are similar, we can write corresponding sides are proportional. Okay, or first we will show this one and then this one. Okay, so here if we take triangle CMB and RNQ, okay, so here if we multiply by half, okay, so I am taking this ratio, so AB by PQ is equal to BC by, we want this CMB, no? Okay, so BC by QR, okay, I am taking this ratio, AB by PQ is equal to BC by QR. Here we have to multiply by half, so half AB upon half PQ is equal to BC by QR. So half AB, so half AB we will get BM because we want triangle CMB. So here I am taking BM. Okay, so half AB, that is BM upon half PQ. So half PQ we will take here QN. So BM by QN is equal to BC by QR. Okay, now see here, BM by QN is equal to BC by QR. Now we, if we show this angle B and angle Q are equal, then we can write triangle CMB and triangle RNQ are similar by SAS criteria. Okay, because here BM by QN proportional with BC by QR, and angle between these two sides is angle B and angle Q. Okay, so angle B and angle Q are equal, this is already given because triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR, so here angle B and angle Q equal, and this proportional this ratio we have, so we can write triangle CMB similar to triangle RNQ by SAS criteria. So here again we have to write in triangle CMB and triangle RNQ, this BM by QN is equal to BC by QR, and angle B is equal to angle Q, this is given. So we can write triangle CMB similar to triangle RNQ. Okay, now here triangle CMB and triangle RNQ similar by SAS criteria, so right here by SAS similarity criteria. So by SAS similarity criteria, these two triangles are similar. Now we have to show that this CM by RN is equal to AB by PQ. Now these two triangles are similar, so we can write corresponding sides are proportional. So CM by RN is equal to, I am taking CB and RQ or QR, so CB by RQ. Okay, so CM by RN is equal to CB by RQ, but we know that CB by RQ or BC by QR, that is equal to AB by PQ, so instead of this we can write AB by PQ. So CM by RN is equal to AB by PQ. So here reason is CB by QR is equal to AB by PQ. So here CM by RN is equal to AB by PQ. This is proof of first one. CM by RN is equal to AB by PQ. Okay. So first, here triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR given. By using this, we can write here corresponding angles equal, corresponding sides are proportion. Okay. Then we have to take this ratio. Here multiply by half, so we will get half AB upon half PQ, that is BM by QN is equal to BC by QR, and angle included in these two sides, that is angle B and angle Q, that is equal because triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. So we can write these two triangles similar by SAS criteria. Okay, and after that we have to write corresponding sides of these two triangles. Okay, now we will take second example. Okay, second example is, if triangle ABC and triangle PQR are similar and their perimeters are 20 cm and 30 cm, and if AC is 6 cm given, we have to find the length of side PR. Okay, so we know that if triangles are similar, then sides are proportional and their perimeters are also proportional. Okay, so we saw here one remark. So if triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, their perimeters are proportional with their corresponding sides. So first we have to write triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR. Now here we have to find AC. So AC is corresponding with PR. We can write here AC by PR is equal to perimeter of triangle ABC divided by perimeter of triangle PQR. So here AC is given 6, so 6 divided by PR is equal to ABC, perimeter of ABC is 20, so 20 divided by perimeter of PQR is 30, so 20 by 30. So we can write here 6 by PR is equal to 2 by 3. So if you find PR, that is 2 PR is equal to 18, PR is equal to 9 cm. Okay, so we have to use this remark, if two triangles are similar, their corresponding sides are in proportional and it is proportional with perimeters also. Okay, so if here we have to find PR and PR is corresponding with AC, so AC is given, so therefore we have to take here AC by PR is equal to perimeter of triangle ABC divided by perimeter of triangle PQR. Okay, then put here values and find PR. Okay, so here PR is 9 cm. Okay, so now we will take next example. Example is, if two triangles are equilateral, then prove that the ratio of their respective sides, medians, angle bisectors and altitudes are equal. Okay, means here actually these are 4 or 5 examples, means we have to show that if two triangles are equilateral, then first we have to show that their respective sides are in proportional, then if triangles are equilateral, then respective sides and medians are in proportional, respective sides and angle bisectors are in proportional, and respective sides and altitudes are in proportional. Okay, so we will take one one. So here what is given, if we consider two triangles ABC and, so triangle ABC and triangle PQR are equilateral triangles, okay, so we know that equilateral triangles are similar, so triangle ABC and triangle PQR are obviously, these two triangles are similar. Okay, so if two triangles are similar, we can write angles are equal, so angle A is equal to angle P, angle B is equal to angle Q, angle C is equal to angle R, and corresponding sides, that is AB by PQ is equal to BC by QR is equal to AC by PR. Okay, now we have to show that the ratio of the respective sides and medians are equal. Okay, so if we take, this is first triangle ABC and triangle PQR, these two are equilateral and this AM, suppose AM and PN are medians, so here we have to show that AB by PQ is equal to AM by PN, that is respective sides and their medians are in proportional, so AM by PN. Okay, so AB by PQ and AM by PN, we have to show that are in proportional. Okay, so for that we have to show that these two triangles are similar, triangle ABM and triangle PQN. Okay, so how we show that these two triangles are similar? Here what is given, ABC and PQR are similar, so we can write sides are in proportion. So we have to use this ratio of proportional sides. Okay, so in triangle, okay, now we start to prove this AB by PQ is equal to AM by PN. So first we have to write in triangle ABM, or first in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, we have to take this proportional sides, that is AB by PQ is equal to BC by QR. So again, if you multiply by half to this BC, so AB by PQ is equal to half BC divided by half QR. Okay, so we can write here AB by PQ is equal to half BC, we can write, that is BM, and half QR, that is QN, because AM and PN are medians, so these are equal. Okay, so we can write half BC, that is BM, and half QR, that is QN. Okay, so now if we consider these two triangles, triangle ABM and triangle PQN, we will get here ratio AB by PQ is equal to BM by QN. Okay, and angle B is equal to angle Q. It is already given because triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. So we can write in triangle ABM and triangle PQN, AB by PQ is equal to BM by QN, and angle B is equal to angle Q. This is given because triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. So by SAS criteria, we can write triangle ABM similar to triangle PQN by SAS criteria. Okay, now if these two triangles are similar, we can write corresponding sides of these two triangles which are in proportional. So ABM and PQN, means here we can write AB by PQ is equal to, now here I am taking AM and PN, so AB by PQ is equal to AM by PN. Okay, so corresponding sides or respective sides are proportional with corresponding medians, that is AM by PN. Okay, similarly we have to show that for angle bisectors and altitudes. Okay, now only I am only explaining here what we have to do for angle bisectors and altitudes. Okay, after that you will write this. Okay, so here if I am taking angle bisectors, so triangle ABC and triangle PQR are similar triangles. Okay, now here AM and PN, or take different name, that is AL and PS suppose. So AL and PS are angle bisectors. So angle bisector means these two angles are equal. AL is angle bisector of angle A, PS is angle bisector of angle P. Okay, so these two angles are equal, and here these two angles are equal. Okay, now we have to show that AB by PQ is equal to AL by PS. Okay, now how we show that these two triangles are similar? Here we can use AA criteria, because here angle B is equal to angle Q, already given, and angle A is equal to angle P. Okay, if we multiply by half, that is half angle A is equal to half angle P, so we can show that this angle equal to this angle. Okay, so by AA criteria we can show that triangle ALB similar to triangle PSQ. Okay, so shortly I am writing here in triangle, we have to show this in triangle ALB and triangle PSQ, angle B is equal to angle Q, this is given, and angle A is equal to angle P, this is also given, but we don't want angle A and angle P, we want half of angle A. So if we multiply by half, so half angle A is equal to half angle P. So half angle A we can write angle BAL, and half angle P we can write angle QPS. Okay, so angle BAL is equal to angle QPS, means these two angles are equal and these two angles are equal corresponding. So we can say that triangle ALB similar to triangle PSQ, and if triangle ALB similar to PSQ, we can write AB by PQ is equal to AL by PS. Okay, and similarly you can prove by a proof for altitudes. Okay, so if AL and PS are altitudes, means this is perpendicular, so instead of this angle only we have to take this angle, these two angles are equal and these two angles are equal, so we can show that ALB triangle and PSQ triangle are similar by using AA criteria. Okay, now we will take next example. Okay, next example is, in a rectangle ABCD, BC is equal to 2AB, a point E lies on the ray CD such that CE is equal to 2BC, prove that BE perpendicular to AC. So here figure is not given, we have to draw first figure. ABCD is rectangle such that BC is equal to 2AB, okay, and another one, E lies, point E lies on the ray CD such that CE is equal to 2 times BC. Okay, so we have to draw this ray CE and this CD, we have to increase this, and point E is there, and we have to show that BE perpendicular to AC, this BE perpendicular to AC, means we have to show that this angle is a right angle. Okay, now what is given here, BC is equal to 2AB. Okay, so if we suppose that AB is equal to 1 unit, then BC is equal to 2 unit, because BC is equal to 2AB. So here we have to write these units, AB is equal to 1 unit, BC is equal to 2 unit. Now next is given, CE is equal to 2BC. So CE is equal to 2BC, but here BC is given 2 times AB, so 2 into 2AB, that is 4AB. Okay, so CE is equal to 4AB, so we can write CE, that is a 4 unit, because AB is 1 unit, so if we put 1 unit here, we will get CE is equal to 4 unit. Okay, so CE is equal to 4 unit, so this CE we can write, that is a 4 unit, so this is 4 unit. Okay, now here by using this, C is equal to 4AB, we'll get ratio of AB and C. So if we write this, C is equal to 4AB, AB by C we can write here, that is equal to 1 by 4. So AB by C, that is a 1 by 4. Now we can show that these two triangles, triangle AOB and triangle COE, are similar by AA criteria, because these two are vertically opposite angles. Okay, these two are vertically opposite angles, and alternate angles we can take this angle and this angle, because AB and CD are parallel lines, ABCD is rectangle, so AB and CD are parallel lines, this is transversal, so these two angles are equal and these two are vertically opposite angles. So we can show that triangle AOB and triangle COE are similar, okay, by AA criteria. So I am showing these two triangles are similar. So triangle in triangle AOB and triangle COE, angle AOB is equal to angle COE, vertically opposite angles, and angle OAB is equal to angle OCE. This is alternate angles. So angle OAB and angle OCE, these are alternate angles. So these two triangles, triangle AOB similar to triangle COE. Now triangle AOB and triangle COE are similar, so we can write ratio, that is AO by, here first write by AA criteria. Now we can take corresponding sides or proportion. So AO by CO is equal to OB by OE is equal to AB by C. Now AB by CE, we have ratio is 1 by 4. So these two ratio also we will get 1 by 4. That is AO by OC is equal to 1 by 4 and OB by OE is equal to 1 by 4. Because AB by CE is 1 by 4. Since AB by CE is 1 by 4. Okay. Now if we find this, OC is equal to 4 times OA. This OC we will get 4 times OA. So if we convert this, if we convert in terms of AC, so value of OC, that is a, if OC is 4 times OA, means here OA is 1 unit, OC is 4 unit, so total AC is 5 unit. So we can write OC, that is equal to 4 by 5 AC. Similarly, OB is 1 unit, OE is 4 unit, so total B is 5 unit. So we can write this OE is equal to 4 by 5 BE. Okay. Now we have to find here BE is given, that is B we can find, because here in triangle BCE, this is 4 unit, this is 2 unit, so we can find BE by Pythagoras theorem, because this is a right angle triangle. Okay, so now we are going to find first BE. So here in triangle BCE, angle C is equal to 90 degree, so by Pythagoras theorem we can write here BE square is equal to BC square plus C square. So here BC square, that is 2 square, plus C square, that is a 4 square. So 2 square plus 4 square, so 4 plus 16, that is a 20. So BE square is equal to 20. BE is equal to root 20, or we can write 2 root 5. So BE is equal to 2 root 5 unit. Okay. Now by using this, BE is equal to 2 root 5 unit, we can find OE. Okay. Okay. Here we have to find AC also. So AC we can find by using triangle ABC, because in triangle ABC, this is AB is 1 unit, BC is 2 unit. So total AC is equal to, we can find by Pythagoras theorem. So in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. So AB, that is 1 square, plus BC square, that is 2 square, is equal to AC square. So 1 plus 4 is equal to AC square. So AC is equal to, or AC square is equal to 5. AC is equal to root 5 unit. Okay. Now AC is equal to root 5 unit. B is equal to 2 into root 5 unit. So by using this B and AC, we can find OC and OE. Okay. So OC is equal to 4 by 5 AC. Okay. Now again I will explain this, how we will get OC is equal to 4 by 5 AC. Here we will get OC is equal to 4 times OA. Okay. OC is equal to 4 times OA. So if we consider, if we take this line segment and this is OC and this is OA. So if this is 4 unit, this is 1 unit. So total AC is 5 units. So we can write OC by AC, that is 4 upon 5. So OC is equal to 4 by 5 AC. Similarly for OE, this OE is 4 unit, OB is 1 unit, so total B is 5 unit or 5 parts. So we can write ratio OE by B, that is 4 by 5, or OE, value of OE we can write 4 by 5 B. Okay, now here we have to find first value of OC. So 4 by 5 AC, AC is root 5 unit, so this is 4 by 5 into root 5, or we can write this 5, we can write here root 5 into root 5, and this root 5 is here, so 1 root 5 will get cancelled, so 4 upon root 5. So OC is equal to 4 upon root 5. After that OE, OE is equal to 4 by 5 BE. So 4 by 5 B is equal to 2 root 5. So 2 root 5 unit. So 4 2s are 8, 8 root 5. And upon again this 5 we can write root 5 into root 5. So 1 root 5 will get cancelled. So OE is equal to 8 upon root 5 units. Okay. Now we will get OC and OE. So we can show that OC square plus, if we show that OC square plus OE square is equal to CE square, then we can write this angle is a right angle. Okay, so we will find first OC square plus OE square. Okay, now I am rubbing this. Okay, so first we will find OC square plus OE square. So OC square is, OC is 4 by root 5, so 4 by root 5 bracket square plus OE, that is 8 by root 5 bracket square. So this is 16 by 5 plus 64 by 5. Okay, so we will get 80 upon 5, that is 16. So OC square plus OE square we will get 16, and if we take CE square, C square is equal to 4, its square, C is a 4 unit, so 4 square, that is a 16. So from this and this we have C square is equal to OC square plus OE square. So in triangle OCE, if C square is equal to OC square plus OE square, then we can write this angle, that is angle COE, that is a 90 degree by converse of Pythagoras theorem. So in triangle COE, C square is equal to OC square plus OE square, therefore angle COE is equal to 90 degree by converse of Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so by converse of Pythagoras theorem we can write angle COE is 90 degree. So if COE is 90 degree, we can say that BE perpendicular to AC. If this angle is 90 degree, BE perpendicular to AC. So we can write here BE perpendicular to AC. Okay, now we will see next example. Okay, next example is in triangle PQR, PQ is equal to PR, X is a point on PR such that QR square is equal to PR into XR. Prove that QX is equal to QR. Okay, so first we will draw diagram. In triangle PQR, what is given? PQ is equal to PR. So PQ is equal to PR means angle Q is equal to angle R also. Okay, so if means triangle PQR is isosceles triangle, so in isosceles triangle base angles are equal. X is a point on PR, so suppose X is a point here such that QR square, so if we join this, Now we have this QR square is equal to PR into XR, and we have to prove that QX is equal to QR. Okay, so we'll start to prove this. Okay, so what we have, QR square is equal to PR into XR. Okay, so QR square we can write QR into QR is equal to PR into XR. Okay, so if we shift this PR and if we shift QR here, so we will get ratio, that is QR by PR is equal to XR by QR. Okay, now if we take these two triangles, triangle PQR and triangle XQR. Okay, so in triangle PQR and triangle QXR. Now in these two triangles, we can use this ratio QR upon PR is equal to XR upon QR. Okay. Now here QR is the side of this triangle XQR. PR is the side of this triangle, okay, PR. XR is the side of this triangle QXR, and QR is the side of triangle PQR, okay. And in these two sides, if we take QR and XR, so this QR and XR, in this two side, angle R is included for this triangle XQR and for PR and QR. So PR and QR, angle R is included. So angle R is common for this both triangle in triangle PQR and triangle QXR. Angle R is common angle, so this is common angle. So we can write these two triangles are similar by SAS criteria. So triangle QXR similar to triangle PQR. Okay, triangle QXR similar to triangle PQR. So here this, write these names in order, because this angle R is equal to angle R. Okay, here QR and XR are equal, so angle Q is corresponding with angle X. So angle Q is corresponding with angle X, or this angle Q is corresponding with angle X. Okay, and angle P is corresponding with Q. So P is corresponding with Q. So write these names in order. Okay, after that we have to prove that QX and QR are equal. So by using these two triangles are similar by SAS criteria, if triangles are similar, corresponding angles are equal. So we can write angle QXR equal to angle PQR. Okay, this angle QXR equal to angle PQR. QXR means this angle equal to angle PQR means this total angle. Now angle PQR and angle PRQ are equal. Okay, so instead of PQR we can write PRQ. So angle QXR is equal to angle PRQ, because what is given, PQ is equal to PR given, therefore angle PQR is equal to angle PRQ. So instead of PQR we have to replace by PRQ. Okay, now we will get angle QXR, this angle equal to angle PRQ. Okay, so if we take instead of PRQ we can write name XRQ. So angle PRQ we can write angle XRQ. So angle QXR is equal to angle XRQ. So if we take this triangle XQR, and in this triangle these two angles are equal. Okay, so if these two angles are equal, corresponding sides means opposite sides are also equal, means QX is equal to QR. So we have to prove same, QX is equal to QR. Okay, so if we take in triangle QXR, angle QXR is equal to angle XRQ, then we can write QX is equal to QR. Okay, side opposite to equal angles. Okay, so which are equal? Side opposite to equal angles are equal. So QX is equal to QY. Okay, that is the proof of this. So main is this. First we have to show that these two triangles are similar, PQR and QXR. Okay, and write these names are in given order or proper order. First write these names, then you can find which angles are equal, corresponding angles. Okay, so important step is this, to write name of triangle in proper order. Okay.